Freedom to protest has long been a major part of what makes America one of the greatest countries in the world. The urge to protest against something that is unjust is an urge that many people follow through with. Those people must then consider what types of protests are the most effective. There are demonstrations, sit-ins, symbols, and breaking unjust laws, all of which can be done non-violently. However, there is a method of protest that seems to be more effective than any other protest ever accomplished before. Music. Throughout American history, racism, war, and segregation have caused persistent social unrest. In the 1920s, a new type of music, jazz, became popular. This combined European melodies and instruments with African rhythms and percussive ideas. The combination of cultures helped to speed up integration of African Americans in the U.S. Some influential musicians began to push for an end to segregation. A major example of this was Duke Ellington. He did not play for segregated audiences, and he commanded respect. It was as if the president was on tour, he said. Another example was Louis Armstrong, who played with black and white musicians, contributing to the unifying of the races. He also wrote a song about racism called Black and Blue.
My only sin is in my skin. What did I do to be so black and blue?
He, along with many others, would play in integrated jazz clubs, where people of any race would be either playing or just listening. Norman Granz, an impresario who organized jazz concerts and founded several jazz record labels, contributed to integration by not allowing bands to play for segregated audiences. He explained, "The whole reason for jazz at the Philharmonic was to take it to places where I could break down segregation." By using this new music that so many enjoyed, people were forced to desegregate, and this would break the ice, so to speak. The people would eventually come to realize that they have nothing to fear when it comes to racial integration. In the 1960s, popular focus shifted to the Vietnam War.
Come, you masters of war.
Being the first war to ever be televised, people could see all the violence and the destruction, and some people began to wonder, why are we involved in this? What possible reason could there be to bring so much devastation? And these questions rang out through hundreds of protest songs by artists such as Bob Dylan, Pete Seeger, Arlo Guthrie, Phil Oakes, Country Joe, and John Lennon. One of the most famous examples is Bob Dylan's Blown in the Wind.
Yes, and how many deaths will it take till he knows too many people have died? Then some of my friends. Is a blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
This song asks several rhetorical questions that try to reveal the malevolence of the war. Another song that directly protests the Vietnam War is Feel Like I'm Fixin' to Die by Country Joe and the Fish.
Put down your books and pick up a gun. We're gonna have a whole lot of fun. And it's 1, 2, 3. What are we fighting for? Don't ask me, I don't give a damn.
This pointed out the pointlessness of the war in Vietnam, and it pushed for an end to it. Songs like these were played for hundreds of thousands of people at events like Woodstock, Haight-Ashbury, and the Newport Folk Festival. The crowds are agreeing with these anti-war and peace messages because the music speaks to them, and it makes them find a part of themselves they never knew they had. This helps to speed up the anti-war movement. Eventually, when the Vietnam War ended, people became more concerned with domestic issues. As the decades went on, people began to talk a lot more about civil rights issues, especially police brutality. And the problems were reflected in the new style of music, hip-hop, that became popular in the 1980s. The song playing now is called Thieves in the Night by Black Star.
Or is it the mind state that's ill, creating crime rates to fill the new prisons they build? Over money and religion, there's more blood that spills, the wounds of slaves and cotton fields that never heal. What's the deal?
Talks about how even though it seems like a lot of progress has been made, there are still racism and segregation in the modern day. A well-known rap protest song is N.W.A.'s F the Police.
The police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga in the back cause I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority. That is cause I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on and thrown in jail. We can go toe to toe in the middle of a cell.
This is one of the most famous and iconic police brutality protest songs, and it brings attention to the ongoing racial issues that exist to this day. Another protest rapper was Killer Mike, and he wrote a protest song called Burn.
Police in the ghetto, they is killing niggas daily, but when we get to bussing back, they say that we crazy. Prisons overcrowded and schools is too, cause they undereducate you and got a place for you. Yeah, niggas go to prison in new wage slavery, now you knowing why they undereducate your baby.
This is a protest of segregation in school, a problem that would allow many African Americans to be incarcerated more easily, and it calls this cycle New Age Slavery. One of the most brutally honest protest rap artists was Tupac, and he wrote a song called Changes.
Cops give a damn about a Negro, pull a trigger, kill a nigga, he's a hero. Get it back to the kids who the hell cares, one less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers, give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other.
His song discusses many racial issues, including police discrimination, black-on-black crime, race inequality in government positions, and unequal incarceration rates. Music has a major influence on how people think and act, which is why it can speed up social movements. It appeals to the emotional side of people, moving them to be more radical and demanding change. Whether it is jazz, folk, or hip-hop, music of all styles can influence people to improve the society they live in.
We can never go nowhere unless we share with each other. We gotta start making changes. Learn to see me as a brother instead of two distant strangers. And that's how I was supposed to be. How can the devil take a brother if he's close to me? I let it go back to when we played as kids, but then it changed. That's the way it is. Come on, come on.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same.